So last time we did a range test for stop and go traffic in the city, and we received a comment which asks what would be the range in non-stop and go traffic but still in the city.
Mm-hmm.
So that would be like driving smoothly at an average speed of 50 km per hour, I would say.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Okay, then let's start.
Let's go.
Let's go. And we do it exactly as the last time, of course,
mm-hmm.
when Jixuan was first driving, mm-hmm. and like she is still a beginner, so she's still maybe a bit like not so smooth on the pedals, you know, on the acceleration and braking pedal.
Yes.
And then afterwards I try to drive, and of course again I try to drive as smoothly as possible and try to really be as efficient as possible, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And then let's see again at the end our consumption, our energy consumption,
mm-hmm.
and then we can again calculate the range we would get.
Yeah.
So we'll drive now a huge circle around Munich. You know?
It's called the Mittlerer Ring, famous Mittlerer Ring.
Yeah, it's called the Mittlerer Ring. There are several rings around Munich. It's like Minas Tirith, you know, like freaking Minas Tirith. Minas Tirith had three rings of defense, and Munich is very similar. That's why Munich is often called the Minas Tirith of Bavaria. I'm freaking kidding, of course. It's absolutely not called like this, and I'm talking stupid shit. Tunnel, for example, I think took 10 years to build.
Really?
Yeah.
When was that?
It was so long here, I can remember. There was such a long time of construction site here. It took like 10 years almost to build this tunnel, and I don't want to know how much it has costed. And I'm pretty sure in China they would have built it in 1 month. I'm pretty sure in China they would have built this tunnel and 10 other tunnels in 1 month.
Yes, like the Gigafactory, right?
Yeah, like the Tesla Gigafactory, which they are building on an insane speed. I mean, they are building a huge factory in half a year's time. And they started building this year, and apparently it should be finished by late quarter three this year.
Mm-hmm.
So this is crazy. And they will start building cars later this year in a factory that didn't even exist this year. At 134 watt hours per kilometer. That's pretty nice, I have to say. I will of course beat this. I will of course be brutally lower than her. I mean, because I'm so brutally old and experienced. Wise. I'm wise. Like, look at the gray hair. Like, it's like freaking Gandalf already.
Yes, turning,
it's Gandalf
now
the
you're
gray.
Gandalf the gray, and you're turning into Gandalf the white.
A few more decades and I will be freaking Gandalf the White. I will return with even more power. Just imagine that. Oh. So we're now nearing the end. The first part of the test where she's driving, and we're like almost at 30 kilometers now, 28.6 kilometers, and she has an incredible 125 watt hours per kilometers of efficiency. 125 watt hours per kilometer, that's like almost 600 kilometers of range, 580 or something. Like, that's amazing.
What?
I'm so proud of you.
Thanks a lot.
Okay, so we've now covered a distance of 30.2 kilometers. We've driven one full circle around Munich on the Mittlerer Ring. And your efficiency is?
123 watt hours per kilometer.
Not bad. I'm really proud of you. 123 watt hours per kilometer. It's a really good efficiency. That's almost 600 kilometers of range under normal traffic conditions. It will not be easy to beat this. You're setting me under pressure here. So let's see what I can do, right?
Yes, I'm so curious.
Me too. So let's change the profile to Sebastian.
So such that I can get out more easily and yeah. We can get in at all.
Exactly.
Because I'm so small.
Exactly. Yeah, I'm in the driver's seat finally.
And how do you feel?
Oh, I feel so cool. Yeah.
I have to raise my...
So now we're resetting everything, right? Because
yes.
We're like, we want to know it from the beginning, of course. You haven't put on your seatbelt.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then you should, of course, put on the seatbelt. It would not, of course, be so bad if you would put on the seatbelt. I read somewhere that seatbelts are not so bad. They can be quite useful in certain situations. So let's see what I can do, what the experienced driver can do, right? What can the experienced driver do? I think he can work wonders. I don't want to brag or anything, but my driving skills are regarded in driving circles as being quite legendary, without, of course, exaggerating in any way.
Your goal is 120 watt hours per kilometer.
Now you have made like, what did you have, 125?
123.
123? Oh, that sets me under brutal pressure now.
But now it's still okay, I mean it's already like this. In non-rush hours, I cannot imagine what here would look like in 2 hours.
It will be insane. Will be crazy. Hey, look. Do you know what that is?
It's an Audi e-tron.
It's an Audi e-tron, a fellow electric friend.
Okay, we had now a little bit of traffic jam, so our average consumption going up again a little bit.
Yeah.
And you see this, the solid line. Okay, maybe we should start with the dashed line. The horizontal dashed line is the average consumption now for the last 10 kilometers. But now we managed in the last 20 minutes or the half an hour, we managed to keep our average energy consumption far below the standard consumption by Tesla.
Mm-hmm.
I like that.
Yeah, me too.
I only managed to get my energy consumption down after this stretch with all the traffic lights, but now you are already at 123. During this stretch, so it's looking good for you.
Let's see. We will stop exactly at the same spot where you stopped, at the gas station.
Yes.
And then we'll do a comparison.
I'm looking forward to it.
People who are like advancing electric mobility are really important. Really. It's so important to like support Tesla. In my opinion, it's really important for the future of humanity, and I'm really not exaggerating, to support Tesla wherever you can. Because it's one of the most single important companies in the history of humanity. Tesla, SpaceX, like all of Elon Musk's companies, are super important, right?
Absolutely. Use the same road, use the same ground, maybe do an autopilot test in this ring.
Yeah, that would be interesting. Testing the autopilot in the ring.
Yes,
how
because
it behaves.
The ring has nice street marks.
Yeah, that would be highly interesting.
almost there. It's still 100. Now it's 114. Looking good.
This is looking more and more quite perfect, I would say. Wow!
You made it! 114!
114!
You made your goal! I'm so proud of you!
Thanks! Thanks a lot!
So he won again.
So you had 123, which was already very excellent.
Yes.
And I had 114 watt hours per kilometer, so only a 10% difference. Over 600 kilometers of range in an electric car, in city traffic, what the hell's going on?
So if you drive this every day and you don't go on a huge trip on the weekend,
yeah,
you only have to charge your car like twice per month.
Yeah.
If you stay in the city. And we also had the AC on, right?
Yeah, we had the AC on, we have it on now. And basically we had it on like at least 50% of the time, I would say. Without AC, I think you get another 5% more. It could go down to 110 watt hours per kilometer.
And if you want to see any other tests with the Tesla Model 3, please tell us in the comments.
So we hope you had fun with this driving around through the middle ring.
Yes.
And yeah.
And we hope that you like our video and please give us a like. And maybe share it with your friends.
So stay tuned and see you in the next video, right?
Yes, see you.
Ciao.